Hello, welcome to Pike Creek Farm. My name is Renee. Thank you so much for stopping in today. It is November, and that means it is November Soup Spectacular time. This is a fun collaboration put on by Diane, the Canny Nana. She has a great channel. Go check her channel. She's one of the first ones I watched when I started watching YouTube, and so watch her stuff. But she organized this great collaboration. On November 30th, she's going to give away a crock pot. And she's gonna choose the winner from all the channels that are participating in the next 30 days. She's gonna pick from the comments. So make sure you watch all the videos and comment on them. I will have the playlist below and all the channels, and check them out. There's some great new channels, ones that are just getting their start, and you might discover a channel that you really truly want to watch and enjoy. So, Soup Spectacular. Now what I'm doing today is a video on, that's a great recipe. It is a clam chowder, but not the usual clam chowder. It is from Monterey Bay, California. When I was married the first time, when we were first married, we lived in California, and we were about an hour and a half from Monterey Bay and Pebble Beach and all that area, Carmel. And we went there the very first time, and we were on the wharf, and we were strolling up and down, reading all the restaurant menus, trying to figure out where to go eat. And we got to the old Fisherman's Grotto on the end, and they were outside giving little cups sample of their clam chowder. It was the best clam chowder I ever had, and it was different than anyone else's. It's like finely chopped. It's not like a big chunky chowder, and the flavor is amazing. So you could buy the recipe back then in the 80s. It was before internet and all that, where you could, you know, Google and find recipes. So I paid like $10 for this piece of paper for this recipe, which has since become disintegrated and I don't have it, but I have the recipe still. And you can see it online now too. Old Fisherman's Grotto. If you're ever in Monterey, definitely go there. Their food is amazing. And we moved back to Michigan. We hadn't made it yet, and so we decided to make it. And I didn't understand some of the stuff. So I called the restaurant and they were so kind. I forget what they called it, but basically it was just half and half. But they had a different name for it, like coffee creamer or something. And then I wasn't sure if they meant like, you know, coffee creamer or half and half. It was half and half. And they gave me the hint of chopping everything up in a food processor. So that's what I'm gonna do today. So it's finely minced. And they also said to cook it in a crock pot to prevent it from scorching. Otherwise, you need to use a double boiler on the stove or watch it like a hawk, because it has milk and cream, heavy cream, and half and half. So it would burn very easily. So, but in the crock pot, not an issue. So let's get on with November Soup Spectacular and making Monterey Bay Old Fisherman Grotto's clam chowder. I have a stock pot on the stove, and I am going to get a whole stick of butter melting. And then I'm going to chop up the vegetables and the bacon and get them all cooking. That's the first step. So, put the butter in the pan. Now I'm going to add, calls for one potato, and I'm going to kind of chunk it up. Calls for one stalk of celery and one carrot. You want them all finely chopped. And when I called the restaurant, they suggested doing it in a food processor. And theirs were very small, minced, not like just chopped. So I'm going to pulse this and get this going. I'll turn the sound down for you, or fast forward through it. There's one chunk of carrot. I'll add that with the bacon. The bacon also goes in here. So otherwise the rest is very finely
chopped up. So I'm going to add this to the pan on the stove. One chunk of potato back in, and the bacon. I have a little bit more bacon than what they called for, but it's got quite a bit of fat on it, so I don't think it's going to end up being too much, actually. Let me grab a towel for my hands. So there's no big pieces of bacon in this finished product. It's very minced. So break it up some, spread it back around. Bacon's kind of funky when it gets chopped up like this. So if you're new to my channel, I do videos on canning, on baking and cooking, and I also do vintage recipes from my mom and my grandma and different family members. Sort of like trying to preserve the family recipes and history this way, because, you know, my kids and probably my grandkids won't be using cookbooks like we did, so, and recipe cards. Also, I tell a little bit about life here on Pike Creek Farm. It's almost 8 acres in the thumb of Michigan, and we've lived here for a couple of years, and we have chickens now, and we have 2 dogs, and there's a creek, and we just truly enjoy it. Gardening. And that should do it. So food processor really does make the process of making this soup very simple. You want to cook this over a medium heat until the vegetables are tender. And be careful that it doesn't scorch. Keep stirring it. Adjust the heat as needed for your stove. And then when they're tender, we will add in 1½ cups of flour. Okay, it's been cooking for a little bit now. Keeping it from sticking on the bottom. And this will be cooking in a crock pot, so it will cook for a while. So we're going to add 1½ cups of flour. There we go. I had 1/2 cup measuring cup. So I'm going to get this all mixed in. We want to cook it for a few minutes. The recipe says 2 minutes. And this will become all thick. I think it usually takes me a little longer than exactly 2 minutes to get it all mixed in. At this point, you would add the clam juice, which I don't have, unfortunately. So I'm going to add it says 2 cups. I'm going to add 1 cup of vegetable broth, and we'll see what, by the time I add the clam juice from the clams, if it needs to be thinned down, then I will add more vegetable broth. Two cups of milk. Two cups of 1½ cups. Splashed my glasses. I'm really good at getting stuff on my glasses. And then 2 cups of cream, heavy cream. This is not a low-calorie soup. So I'm gonna use a whisk now to get this all mixed. Turn the heat down. And I'm gonna get this all incorporated. And then I'm gonna transfer it over to the crock pot and add the black pepper, the garlic, the clams with the clam juice. It also says you can add a half a teaspoon of clam base. I have never found clam base around here. And we've even gone to our nearest city. Not that it's a very big city, and they don't have it. Takes a while for it all to heat up. But you're going to want this all mixed in and heated up before you add it to the crock pot, because it won't blend together in there. It calls for 3 cloves of garlic. I'm just going to use this kind. And each, so it's 3 teaspoons of the pre-chopped. And I'm doing generous teaspoons because the garlic flavor was always very pronounced in this. Every time we would go over to Carmel and Monterey quite often, like every couple of months. It was like our favorite thing to do when we lived in California. And we would always go to this restaurant. When my parents came out to visit us, we took them there, and they were so looking forward to it. Calls for half a teaspoon of pepper. This is a quarter teaspoon. I'm going to open up the clams now and add them. And you can use fresh or frozen or canned clams. I have only ever made it with canned. This is not sticking on the bottom. And you can thin it down by adding more of the broth or clam juice. I'm going to transfer this to a crock pot to make sure it doesn't scald. I realized I forgot to add onion to the vegetables. So what I'm going to do is add some dehydrated onion, and they will reabsorb in there. It's supposed to be 1 medium onion diced, so this will serve the purpose. And I am going to add some more of the vegetable broth. Okay, let's see how well I can do this. Ooh, splash. So I'm gonna put this on low for 2 hours, and it will switch over to warm actually then. And I'm going to go into my office now. I have to go into to work, and my husband will keep an eye on this for me. And there we go. I'll bring you back and show you what it's like and how we serve it. And I have the vegetable broth standing nearby in case it needs any thinning down. But So it's pretty simple to pull together. And like I said, you could cook it on the stove still. A double boiler is what they suggested. You don't want it to scorch, and it's so easy with all those high fat dairy products in it. So I'm gonna go to work and I'll come back and show you what it looks like later. And soup is done. I'm gonna dish it up. Got sourdough bread I just took out of the oven to warm up. And we have dinner. It's hot. Sorry to steam you. Soup and bread. So good. This is such a good recipe. It brings back so many memories of walking on that wharf and our reaction when we tasted it. And of course, we had it with sourdough bread. My word of the day, which is part of this, there's gonna be some extra prizes for word of the day. And my word of the day is chowder. So make sure you put that down below in the comments. And make sure you comment to be eligible for the prize drawing on November 30th. And I want to thank Diane so much for doing this. And I was excited to be able to share this recipe with everyone. If you like this recipe, if you push the like button, it really helps. And if you want to see more videos on cooking and canning and vintage recipes and come along on our journey at Pike Creek Farm, push the subscribe button, please. And we'll see you next time at Pike Creek Farm. Right.